Good morning. Welcome to a very special edition Raw Vlog. It's Thursday, April 19, out here in Sydney, Australia, this weekend for the Sydney Fitness Expo. Well, it's not weekend yet, it's Thursday. We're out here to set up for the Sydney Fitness Expo this weekend. Here with the fellas.
Big Swole.
Hey, hello, how's it going?
Boss Josh.
What up?
And Big Nevos somewhere.
Jeez.
He's showering.
Shower.
Before he goes to the gym.
Starting this Thursday morning off, Boss Josh and I are going to go hit some cardio around the streets of, I was going to say peace, let's go streets of not peace here in Sydney. Although by the time if we get to Darling Harbour, it should be pretty peaceful.
I'd hope so.
It's just getting through the city.
Yeah, you're going to get through
all
the mayhem
to Darling Harbour. Big Swole and Big Nevos are going to go and train. What are you guys going to train this morning?
We're going to do lats and biceps.
Train
lats?
Lats and biceps. Figure that one out.
When you say lats, you mean like
I mean lats.
Pull-ups, pull-downs?
That's just all lats. That's it. So it's like back, but you split it into like width and thickness.
Yeah.
So it's just all like pull-downs and pull-overs and all lats.
There you go.
Yeah. And then biceps.
Crazy. I didn't even know that was a thing.
Apparently
that's a thing. All right. We're going to get our day started. It's Raw Vlog, baby. Let's go. Here we go, heading down towards the ICC, the International Convention Center here in Sydney. Big Nevos, how was your workout this morning, mate?
Quickly, Utopia.
What time is it?
Your workout?
It was good. We trained, me and JB did back,
yep.
Seven exercises.
I heard that there was a lat and bicep workout going down.
Five lat, it was, yeah, just purely lat. So no kind of row.
No rows, no deadlifts.
Just lat.
We've come up with a solution, right? If you can't bring your waist in, you just make your lats look bigger.
Yeah.
And it gives you that perception. So that's what we're all about. Not getting leaner, getting your lats bigger.
Makes sense.
Genius.
Makes sense.
You want
Speaking...
some salt? I found it in my f***ing bag.
Like... No, I don't want salt, but I do want to quiz you real quick on these very toit shorts you're wearing.
They are extremely toit. You know when you use like the, yeah. You know when you like use the guides on like websites to buy shorts?
Yeah.
They're just skew-iff too much, man. Probably could have gone a size up.
I was just going to say, Ron, you have a massive erection.
No, I don't. It's just the way the shorts are sitting.
It's the
it's the pattern in the pants.
Anyway, Bosh, how was our cardio this morning, man?
It's delightful.
Good. We're still doing it, technically.
Yeah, it doesn't stop. I don't know why you guys are doing it. You know, you're pretty much walking there and back. It's like cardio anyway.
Yeah.
Well, we did. This is the exact route that we walked this morning. We walked down.
Like, settle down, mate.
Oh, God. I heard a thing go.
He actually doesn't want to set this booth up that much. He's going to jump in front of traffic.
He's going
to
neck himself.
Oh, Jesus.
All right, so we're heading down towards the ICC. We will see you guys when we get there. This is always the challenge that we have every year here at the Sydney Fitness Expo, is figuring out how the f*** to get into the ICC. It,
you know, they've got so many doors, it wouldn't be that hard, but yeah.
So many doors, none of them f***ing open.
No.
And I can't remember what we did last year, how we ended up cracking the code.
Yeah, and there are people on the inside, they're looking at us. they don't give a single f***.
They like look up, notice you, and then ignore you.
Exactly.
Go back to what they're doing.
Yeah.
And go, ah. These guys, back again, trying to figure out how to get in.
Damn bodybuilders.
Oh, shit.
His knee has any luck.
No bingo. All right, we're going to keep trying. Catch you guys inside. Finally, we made it inside. We found the unlocked door. We got our safety vest. Big Nevos.
Hello.
We're here at our Massive Joe's mini booth location.
We found it.
How did they do that?
Our stock has arrived on time.
Which is good. That's why you ran to lunch slot.
So that's our, this is pretty cool. You guys haven't seen this before because this is the first time we've exhibited with the mini booth, or as we call it, the Euro booth, because it's our international apparel booth. And those of you who know how the Massive Joe's mega booth packs down into like six crates, this is how the mini booth packs down.
Everything you use is smaller.
It's like a little Fiat.
Yeah.
So our booth is in there, our stock has arrived as well.
We are going to get straight stuck into it and get this booth set up. Let's go. Alright, so it is just after 11:30 in the AM. We have been building the Massive Joe's Euro booth, aka the mini booth, for about 2 hours now, Bosch?
Yeah.
About 2 hours?
Yeah.
And thoughts so far?
F***ing killing it. We're doing this. We're giving it a right old root.
Seriously, we're absolutely crushing it. It's coming together. It's coming together better than the first time we put it together, and yeah.
That in itself is really quick. So this is like, I mean, look at it. It's
no one's got angry yet.
Yeah.
No one's got angry. Everyone's chilled out.
Yeah.
So I'm going to say it's a win so far.
It is.
No, it's
so far, so good. So pretty much the only things left to do are install the internal graphics. So all of this booth at the moment is completely bare skeleton. So there's internal vinyl graphics that go through the entire booth to make it look all pretty. And then just to stock it. And that's it.
And that's it. Like, what is it now, 12?
We're gonna go. Even, as you guys can see, all the electrical's done.
Yeah, well, so we're gonna grab a bite to eat, and roll stuff, grab some water and shit, come back and nail this by like 2 o'clock.
I would say that.
Yeah.
Considering we've done this much in 2 hours, I'd say another 2 hours, we're done.
Yeah.
All right, let's go eat. So ever since I got back from Mexico earlier this week, I've been telling the fellas, I can't wait to go back. So they decided,
this is the next best thing. Bring Mexico to you, man.
It'll do. It'll do.
If the mountain won't come to Muhammad, no. If Muhammad,
what's the saying?
Something to do with Muhammad and mountains.
And it doesn't really apply to Mexico, but we're here at what is this place called?
Mad Mex.
Mad Mex, and we're smashing some games.
Yeah, man.
Except for this guy who had to be different.
Yeah. I don't even know what kind of bowl it is. It's got honey and peanut butter in there, and a salad.
Is it a knee movement bowl?
No. It's good, but not that good.
Nothing's quite as good as a knee movement bowl.
It's not.
Back at the ICC, ready to put in a little bit more work. Let's get this booth finished off. Let's go. And just before 5 in the PM, and we are done, fellas.
I thought we'd be done by 3, though.
Yeah.
I thought 3.
Oh, look, it's the first time we've ever put this booth together.
Yeah.
And we've customized the configuration. So there's a lot. This is the last little things of trying to figure out what we're going to do with the apparel and how we're going to display stuff.
I was. Yeah. If you think about it, if you put the time, so we started at 9:30. You need to stand up. You're like
okay,
too down low. When you're doing this, you're not vlogging. Now we're vlogging. We're vlogging,
sorry,
right?
Sorry.
So we started at 9:30.
Yep.
We had an hour break.
We've pretty much got the whole structure built in midday.
So we've been going. We've done it in less than 6 hours.
Yeah.
I was actually a little bit overwhelmed, or I should say, I underestimated the amount of apparel that we have for this booth. Like. Give him a bit of a tour, Bosch.
Imagine if it was pre-hung, though.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I know.
It would have been done at, like, 3 o'clock.
Yeah, if we didn't have to hang everything up, that would have been a lot quicker. So that's a note on the list for next year, or the next expo.
Pick another pallet and make it pre-hung.
Because the problem was the pre-hung stuff takes up way too much space.
Yeah.
And we didn't have that much space booked in to take it here, so we had to take up the compacted, pre-packaged apparel.
All right, what are we doing? Show us what we're dealing with here, man.
So we have the delicious counter. Behind said, oh, yeah, look at this, just like, These are amazing.
Just quickly, how many comments have we had already from other, exhibitors,
from other exhibitors
about just not the booth as such, but the counter?
The counter displays, too many. Way too many. So behind that, we have cotton races, muscle tanks, we have our dry fit shorts and our two-tone shorts, we have our women's apparel going from our cotton races, outline races, we have the 7/8 tights, the booty shorts, the crop tops. We also have just an additional selection of t-shirts on the ground there, because we have way too many f***ing t-shirts. So many t-shirts. So then over here, what we've got going on here is we have literally one of every single design and every single colorway in size large, purely for shopping purposes.
Display purposes.
Display. We come through, go, oh yeah, sick. Like, well, YT, I love this design, it's awesome. Can I grab that in an extra large? We go, yeah, sure. It either be down there or it's out back. Quick little look into out back just so I can show you guys. That's what we're dealing with. It's not too bad. It's you know. If we had external storage, this could double as a change room, yep. But it is actually a storage room for us.
Big Swell, hello. Hey, hello, how's it going?
So then down here, what we're going to have is we decided we're going to put the Anzac tees. Because obviously we have the Anzac tees, special event coming up. We thought we might as well give them an entire
limited
rack.
Edition 2018. Limited edition. By the time you guys see, well, by the time...
Yeah, it's
probably shouldn't
sorry.
Even have mentioned
yeah,
it.
Like the Anzac
really?
Tees that
the imaginary
or yeah. gone to one of our stores, or you would have come here and already have in your head. You're probably already wearing it right now.
Probably wearing it, yeah. Watching this video.
Yeah, and if you're not, well, that's really
missed
awkward.
That. Awkward.
That's really awkward. Then we move to the supplements. So there was actually meant to be apparel racking here, because this is technically an apparel booth. It's designed to be an apparel booth. So we've customized it and we've brought some of my good old trusty warehouse shelving / expo display shelving. It is delicious stuff. And we've got a range of supplements, so I don't even know where to begin, you know. Gut Right, Hard Test, Burn, Alka-Pure, Laxa-Pure, Overtraining Solution, Machine Fuel, In Focus, Nectar, Rise Pre-Workout,
What's going
Red
on
Blood
here?
Moon,
What's here?
ABC, Ritual.
Are these the imaginary
this
ghost
this
supplements?
This is
going to
be the imaginary ghost supplements that we're going to get.
They're actually ghosts?
Yeah.
They're like,
actually,
they don't exist, they're
yeah.
actually
here,
ghosts.
Here's a tub right here. Here's
do you
tub.
Believe in ghosts?
I do believe in ghosts. Yeah. They're right there. And then some empty sway Tim Tam, of course. And then we can bring it on to the winter section of the apparel. This is where you find all your winter items, such as Cascade crew necks, Cascade hoodies, Cascade zip-ups, and of course the windbreakers, which are actually pretty cool. I busted mine out for the first time last weekend, and it kept me pretty dry. I was actually really surprised. And
no
of course,
shit.
it cut through the wind really well.
That's
like,
what it does.
It cut through, like, I
it
was like,
breaks that
the
shit.
Wind the wind was happening, and I was just like, oh, just cutting through it, man. It was wicked.
So as you guys can see, like, there's a whole shitload of stock in this booth. Much smaller booth, but really, compared to the apparel side of the Massive Joe's mega booth, like, the amount of apparel is very similar.
Well, the apparel booth is just two walls.
Yeah.
That's the thing, and we still have two walls here. It's a 6x3 instead of a 6x6, but it is dense.
So I think that's why it's taken us longer than we expected, because the actual booth build took us about 4 hours. And
no,
then we spent like,
mean?
What? No, no,
no.
Not
like,
even.
Nah, not even. Like,
okay, let's say 3 hours,
yeah.
And then we spent the rest of the time, like, hanging f***ing apparel and shit.
Yeah.
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 2 hours. Anyway, we are done here. We are locked, loaded, ready to go. Record time with the first ever build of the Massive Joe's mini booth, aka the Euro booth.
Oh, there's our Euros.
Euros.
Very nice Euros.
All right, we're going to get out of here, and we'll catch you guys back at the apartment. Let's go. Quick stop back at the apartment to grab a meal, get changed, and we are off once again. Off on our way now to City Gym, right, Swole?
I don't know.
City Gym, who picked this gym?
No.
No, Neve?
Big boy.
Neve's pick?
Sir?
City Gym?
Yeah.
Well, Bosch and I are going to train some triceps. What are you training, big dog?
Glutes.
Glutes?
Yeah.
Neve, what are you training, man?
Kickbacks, mainly.
We're doing a Hattie Boyle glute inspired workout.
Is that because we just saw Hattie on the way out?
And she's doing a seminar, so we're like, we'll do the seminar first.
There you go.
Yeah.
So we will catch you guys at City Gym when we get there. All right, here we are. We have arrived at the all new refurbished City Gym here in Sydney. Boss Josh and I are about to train some triceps, big small, big knee.
Glutes, baby. Told you this before.
What are you actually training? Yeah, they're not training glutes.
We're hitting the delts.
Delts. You guys are about to train some delts. We're about to train some triceps. Ain't none to it but to do it. Let's get it on. here at the apartment. Post-workout shakes have gone down. In fact, Bosch and I hit some post-workout sludge, didn't we, Bosch?
Baby.
Elaborate. He's eating candy.
Hide all these wrappers.
Post-workout sludge with some American cereal that we found at a local convenience store, as a matter of fact. Anyway, we are here, and when I say we, I mean Boss Josh, Big Swole Bear, and I are here in the apartment putting in work. Big Nevos is in the shower at the moment. Swole.
He's putting in work too.
You really should not be doing that wearing those glasses, mate.
Why not? Mate, LEG wears them.
What the f*** is going on here?
I am blocking out all the blue light to stop my brain from ticking over.
You know what? This is like no bullshit. The funniest thing is this movie is on TV at the moment, and it's Ali G. For those of you who are unaware, just wait till you see Ali G's outfit. Yeah. And in particular, his glasses.
Orange.
And now they're not going to...
Look at that. And you, I'm mimicking Ali G at the moment.
Respect. Respect.
Respect.
Anyway, we're here in the apartment. We're putting in work. We're going to be putting in work for a little while. What are you working on, Big Spot?
I've got orders coming out of my hanusas, man. I've got to get in
tonight so the guys can pack them tomorrow.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm doing at the moment.
And Boss Josh, I'm going to come around and have a chat with you. What are you working on, brother?
I'm going through the emails at the moment. And then we've got all the online orders to process, the same day delivery orders to make sure they're ready for the pickup in the morning, the click and collect orders. We've got to make sure I've got to do some stuff for the Anzac Day t-shirts, get that shit ready, and just warehouse shit.
And why are you not wearing Ali G glasses?
Oh, I feed off blue light. Love blue light. Like
I would go so far as to say I get off on blue light. In a productivity sense. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
While you're here though, we should really just
that's what went in our post workout.
They were so good.
With what protein did you use?
Yankee fucking doodle. Boom. Patriots way.
Course.
Yeah.
Course.
It's a good combination. I still think the Cinnamon Toast Crunch is probably the best combination, because that was like Cinnamon Toast Crunch cereal with Cinnamon Toast Crunch cereal in a protein powder.
Yeah.
It was more
Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
But peanut butter, especially Reese's peanut butter, you can't go wrong.
All right, let me check with Big Nevos on what he's working on. Neve, what are you working on at the moment, brother?
You don't want to go in there, mate. I tell you what, a lot of the biddies watching this would actually want to see that shit.
The female viewer ratings will go through the roof if you actually walked in there.
Mate, let's be honest. There's no biddies watching this video.
What if they seen Neve naked? That and obviously the guys at the gym tonight, they'd be watching it too.
Oh, shit. Anyway, I'm over here working on, Bosch actually alluded to it, our Anzac Day tees, which launch on Saturday, today being Thursday. So we've got all of our marketing material going live already, but going seriously live tomorrow and then Saturday for the launch at 10 a.m. And we're trying to raise 20 grand this year, fellas. 20 we raised in 2000. Here's some fun facts for you viewers at home. In 2016, our first Anzac Tees, we raised $9,000. And back then it was for, what was the charity? I'm going to say like Wounded Warriors. I reckon it was Wounded Warriors. Yeah. And then last year, 2017, we upped that. We raised $15,000 for Legacy. And this year, 2018, we're upping it again. We're trying to raise $20,000 for CAMS Cause, which is a really cool charity that supports soldier welfare, and in particular focuses on commandos who are recovering from both physical and psychological injuries that they obtain during their service. So really, really cool charity, and I hope that that we can smash our goal of raising $20,000 through selling these shirts.
Come back!
We're trying to get our female viewership up.
Just went from 6 to midnight.
Big knee boss.
Oh, shit. All right, we're going to keep working. We'll catch you guys a bit later on. And then there was two.
It's almost bedtime.
I think it is bedtime. Big swole bears just hit the sack. Where did Bosch go? Bosch like disappeared a while ago. I think Bosch like fell asleep at the desk and decided to go have a nap.
Yeah. No, last night he was hustling at 3 a.m. here, him.
Last night he was. So were you. Both you mother.
I was watching TV.
Yeah. We were both up late. Yeah. I went to bed before both these last night. Anyway, guys, that's a wrap for today's very special edition of Raw Vlog. The first day of 4, possibly 5 days. We haven't decided how many days I'm going to Raw Vlog for, but it's going to be an extended Raw Vlog. It's a very special edition extended Raw Vlog for the Sydney Fitness Expo. As always, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Turn your post notifications on, both on your mobile, your cell phone, and your desktop PC, so you don't miss a beat when it comes to the Massive Joe's YouTube channel. I'm being interrupted by WWE.
The Miz.
What's the Miz?
It's him.
Oh, is that the Miz, is it? Mate,
I don't look at James Arthur. You got him on the
podcast? Yeah. We did the whole Ali G thing. Respect.
Anyway, I'm being interrupted by WWE. Or I'm interrupting Neve watching WWE.
Yeah.
So it's time to go. We'll catch you guys tomorrow. Until then, where are we coming to and from, Neve?
MasterJames.com.
Stay massive.